Spy Guy, we're taking a look at the Spider-Man Noir figure from Marvel Legends. He is part of the Lizard Build-A-Figure wave. And it also marks the reintroduction of another special character here. One of the most used aspects of Marvel Legends history, the Nick Fury jacket. Yet again we get this thing. If you're sick to the back teeth of this as me, please let me know in the comments below. But God, we've had this jacket so bloody often. Anyway, it's not quite as high as the sparkly effect from Scarlet Witch and other figures, but damn, Hasbro know how to reuse stuff. Just over 6 inches tall for this figure. Let's get a look at the packaging very quickly, then we'll go look at Spider-Man Noir and his ever annoying jacket. Very cool John Tyler Christopher artwork on the side of the box, looking very moody and noir. I do like that. Now, he's using in that picture there, probably told to by Hasbro, a kind of reference to this gun here. This kind of slightly crappy gun that we've had before in Hasbro figures, I believe. I think it was... what was his name? I think it was Red Skull. I can't remember. I think we've had this weapon before, but either way, that does not look anything like the gun that Spider-Man Noir has in any comic that I know of. Leave a note. Let me know if I'm wrong. So he's probably been given this by Hasbro, but this is what it's going to be, so it's not his fault. But cool artwork. Gorgeous looking web in the background. We get the display on the back of the box. Reluctant hero Spider-Man Noir battles bad guys and mob bosses alike in 1930s New York City. So clearly... this is not a weapon from the 1930s. It's a kind of slightly futuristic-y weapon, so I don't know why they couldn't give us old pistols. They do have pistols, so they have a problem with weapons. Anyway, moan aside, all of it has a Build-A-Figure part. All of these figures, I should say, have a Build-A-Figure part for the Lizard, which is an epically cool figure. All of these reviews up on the channel. Check him out. And Spider-Man logo up at the top. Spider-Man web in the background, not just that little spider inside down there. And that is it. UPC, if you want to pick it up, there's a link directly under this video to pick it up, where I got it from. And let's get a look at them. So, cape or, I don't know, jacket thing. We'll put that back on in just a minute. What we do get underneath that is a pretty nice looking head sculpt. We've got the kind of the lower part of the mask covered off. We've got the silvery goggles. No real outline to the goggles, and all the stitching on the top of the head. Kind of reminds me of Catwoman, actually, the way the stitching was part of the of her uniform from Batman Returns. This has parts that has been used before, without a doubt. The entire top half, I'm pretty confident. Is this Bucky cap? An old Bucky cap or something? I can't remember. This might be new. I don't know. It looks familiar. These arms are familiar. That is without a doubt. As are the legs. Looks a little Red Skullish. Maybe I'm wrong, don't know, but there's a lot of similarities in this. Boots actually look new. I think they actually are new, the design of them, which is nice because that top half looks quite new. We do get a working holster, begging to be torn off that thing. Really not secured too greatly on that belt, but we do get a working holster and it holds his futuristic pistol. No Spider-Man logo in the back, which I've seen some versions of, I think it's more cosplay. But yeah, pretty nice. He's got a little turtleneck going on up at the top. It's not a bad figure overall. It's yeah, it's not terrible. Let's get a look at the bit of detail, put the jacket on, and we'll talk more about the rest of the figure. So this jacket is not too bad. It doesn't really hinder them all that much in terms of movement. Yeah, it does look good, I guess. But yeah, I don't know. I'm just so sick of having this jacket. Anyway, we get pretty good movement on the figure even with that on. Just thought I'd give you a look at it with the jacket on. Looking very moody and broody. Who has a long black cloak like that nowadays? Or coat, I should say. Remember that? The time in The Matrix where suddenly lots of moody goths would wear this kind of long black jacket. Was that you? You out there? Anyway, don't worry. I'm not shaming you. I'm just saying, hey. Anyway, in terms of the figure's articulation, ball-jointed head, plenty of movement. Pretty good. Well, actually, not that great, actually. No, yeah, that is good. Pretty reasonable kind of articulation going on there. Up at the top, we've got these kind of rather high, to kind of fit the jacket seams, kind of padded shoulders. But it does allow a reasonably okay-ish move of articulation. You get bicep swivel, double joints at the elbows. Leaves an awful gap there, I think, when that does. Look at that. Not that weird. Down to swivel gloves, and they go back and forth too. It's all very black, so I'm sorry if this is hard to see. We get an ab crunch, which is pretty good, I have to say. And we get, just watch the gun in there. And you've got a waist swivel, which is pretty good and unrestricted. Pins as usual up at the top of the legs, down to a thigh swivel, down to double joints at the knees. There is no boot cut, but there is rocking very stiff ankles and deep peck holes for those things that Hasbro never give us. There's a kung fu kick for you. So Spider-Man Noir, good looking figure. There he is next to Spider-Punk, if Spider-Punk would stand up. This is why we need stands. Hasbro, for God's sake, make some stands. Drives me freaking bonkers. I've got to buy stands on top of this. Anyway, you go to Japan, all the figures have stands. For some reason, it's a cheap thing. That's all it is, it's money. I'd pay the extra buck if you just put a damn stand in the thing. Anyway, next to the two, you can see roughly the same size. So Spider Brothers, I think. But again, let us know what you think. Link to buy it directly underneath. Subscribe and all that stuff. You know what to do. And we have a 6-inch show if you didn't. And it's pretty good. We talk about all things 6-inch. I like it because I get to talk about 6-inch figures. Anyway, let us know what you think of Spider-Man Noir. We'll see for more reviews and Marvel Legends coming up.